Dengue, the sequel. You've come to the second part of the video and missed the explanations about the virus, the risk factors, and the investigation. But it's okay, you can still watch it after this. Treatment. The specific treatment for dengue fever is not available yet, but there are several general treatments that can be introduced to patients, such as antipyretics to reduce fever and painkillers to treat muscle or joint pain. However, NSAID or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen and aspirin should be avoided. They thin the blood and can exacerbate the prognosis of disease with hemorrhage risk. For severe dengue, intensive medical care by physicians and nurses can decrease the progression of the disease and the mortality rates from more than 20% to less than 1%. The management of the patient's body fluid volume is critical to severe dengue care. Vaccination against dengue. The first dengue vaccine, Dengvaxia, or CYD-TDV, was licensed in December 2015 and has now been approved by regulatory authorities in around 18 to 20 countries. The use of the vaccine is targeted at populations living in endemic areas, ranging from 9 to 45 years of age, who have had at least one documented dengue virus infection previously. The vaccine is given in 3 doses over the course of 12 months, but its efficacy is a matter of debate. The vaccine is only approved for older children because 2 years after being vaccinated, the younger ones appear to be at increased risk of severe dengue fever and hospitalization. The World Health Organization, WHO, stresses that the vaccine is not the most effective tool. Prevention. A more important matter than treatment and vaccines is controlling the mosquito population and human exposure. So, to avoid getting dengue, our best shot is to avoid getting bitten by the mosquitoes carrying dengue. It is as simple as that. If you are a resident of or traveler to any tropical area where dengue fever is previously reported, prevention can reduce your risk of acquiring it, which includes: stay in air-conditioned or well-screened housing, because the mosquitoes that carry dengue viruses are relatively more active from dawn to dusk. Wear protective clothing, like a long-sleeved shirt, long pants, socks and shoes. Use mosquito repellents, like permethrin, to be applied to your clothing, shoes, camping gear, and bed netting. And most importantly, reduce mosquito habitat. You can lower mosquito populations by eliminating habitats where they lay their eggs at least once a week and emptying and cleaning containers that hold standing water, such as planting containers, animal dishes, and flower vases. Keep standing water containers covered between cleanings. Foreign aid. Recently, scientists from Australia and Indonesia are working together to fight the disease. They turn to another creature, a bacteria called Wolbachia. They inject the bacteria into the mosquito's eggs, breed them in the laboratory, and release them into the wild. Then, the spy mosquitoes will eventually mate with the natural, disease-ridden of their kind. Naturally, their babies will also carry the bacteria from the spy father. It has the ability to disrupt the reproductive process of the mosquito, while also reducing the lifespan of their offspring, preventing the next generation of mosquitoes from spreading dengue altogether. The early results are extraordinary. Adults in areas with previously released mosquitoes have 4 times less chance to have dengue disease, giving us the best hope so far to eradicate the dengue endemic.